YouTube viewers, it's Sincere Michael from Screen Productions, bringing you a new podcast from my segment called The Super Sentai Reveal. And like always, I'm going to speak very loudly, very clearly, and very slowly in case you don't understand it. Also, I'll try to do my best not to read so hard during this recording of this audio podcast, not trying to cause any audio feedback as well. Anyway, let's get into the latest episode of Zoranzo, finally, episode 90. Now, when we last us in the previous episode, Yamato was getting his ass whooped by the evil Zoranzo created by the Death Angels called the World, or I call it the World. Anyway, Zoranzo stopped to finish Yamato off, but out of nowhere, he started to have this weird headache and he forced him to demorph. So Yamato saw that the world was a human, and he was trying to, before Yamato got a word out, or before Zuwa got a word out, he got knocked. And Navia came behind you well and knocked him out and took him back to the spaceship. Before she did, he said, "Oh, there's still some bugs to be worked out with you." So and Navia grabbed you well and her and himself back to the spaceship. So anyway, the other showed up after destroying the latest Death Alien monster. So anyway, and what is saying, you know, making sure that Yamato is okay. So meanwhile, back on Death Alien ship, Master Genis was pulling these weird quotes inside your word body. This is how he's been controlling your word, been brainwashing him and controlling you were. So while Master Genis was doing that, the other Death Lieutenant aliens were like, you know, were kind of impressed about you were, but at the same time, he's still human, he could be undetectable, so basically he might turn against us, but to say Death Alien Zala, and Karma was like, you may be right, but you know, Master Genis is working out the bugs the mind control process, so ain't might not happen. So you say just wait and see, trust me, he's gonna turn against us. So later that night at Yamato's uncle Yamato was telling others that you were his human, you know, maybe it's a way we can save him, and the others were like, "Oh, you fucking crazy, whatnot, you know, he tried to destroy us, and he said, no way, why should we save him after he tried to sell us?" And Yamato said, he must be on some type of mind control or something like that. So basically, the others were, you know, were suggested saving you were after the ass kicking they suffered by him. So anyway, the next day, this new Death Alien monster is sent by Zoro, this bowling monster has the power to set up people as bowling pins, and he transforms to a giant bowling ball, and he knocks the people down, knocks the people in the air like bowling pins. So basically, this new Death Alien monster power. It's kind of stupid, but you know. Anyway, the zoo just started to battle the new Death Alien monster and the Moly foot soldiers. Meanwhile, Master Genis and Navia had finally worked out the bug out out of the brainwashing process of the world. So anyway, Macedonians wanted to change the word to Tacaranus, but Zola says that's my monster down here, so let him finish his job. So anyway. So anyway, it was not going very good for Zola's bowling Death Eddie monster. He was getting him and the Molies were getting his ass kicked, and that's when Nesticus was like, screw this, sit down, and he sent down the world. So came down just in time before the other Zoolanders was about to destroy the bowling pin monster, and the bowling pin monster was like, oh, good, thank God you came to save me, Zoolworld, and Zoolworld gets to toss him and see him flying outside the city, through the sky. So anyway, so once again, the Rangers start to do battle with Zoolworld, but Yamato, the morph and tried to talk to Zoolworld, but so far, his words was not getting through for Zoolworld. Nadia showed up and was fighting the other Zoolanders while Zoolworld was beating the shit out of Yamato. So basically, Yamato got his ass beat, he got beat up, well, and he passed out, he was unconscious. So basically, Tarsus uses Unleashed Beast Form to make a smoke scene, that way they can all escape. So anyway, later that night at Yamato's house, at Yamato's uncle's house, Uncle Mario finished treating Yamato, and Mario said he would be fine, and he asked, what the hell happened to Yamato, and the artist came out with this clever line, Yamato was helping treating this dangerous animal, and he got hurt very badly, and Uncle Mario was like, damn, man, whatever type of animal that was, what did that to you, Yamato is probably a dangerous one, it's a dangerous one, he needs to stay away from. So anyway, so the other Zoolanders was like, maybe Yamato was right, maybe we should try to, thinking over, maybe we should try to, try to somehow free Zoolworld from the Death Alien brainwashing. So the next day, the bowling pin monster showed up at the destruction site and once again attacking people, locking people over like the bowling pin. So anyway, the Zoolanders showed up and they morphed up and started to battle with the bowling pin monster. Once again, Master Guinness wanted to send Zoolworld in, but Zola said no, let my monster handle it. With some clever teamwork and the use of Yamato's to unleash the beast form, they managed to take down the bone pin monster. And once again, Naya beat down, put the quarter in the slot of the monster and made the bone pin this alien monster grow. So last one, you want to some of all the accusers then saw Wild Zoo King and used the bear act to do battle with the bowling king monster. And that's when Master Guinness to say, go ahead, Zoo Wild. And so Zoo Wild showed up in his Megazord and started to do battle. So that gave the So the monster, so the bowling pin monster, that gave the bowling pin monster escape while both niggas up for doing battle. So it looks like two wild niggas had the upper hand for most of the fight. But at that moment, the key being Zua acts. Start to transform into a different color. Turns out it transformed into a go black polar bear. It transforms to the Q bear into Q panda. So basically, the new transforming Q Zord transformed into a black go. That gave the Zoan just the upper hand. So basically, using this opportunity, Yamato hopped into Zoan's Megazord cockpit, took Zoan out of his Megazord cockpit, once again tried to reason with him, but he once again kicked the shit out of Yamato and forced him to do more. The others showed up. Out of the Megazord and whatnot, and tried to help Yamato to reason with him. And Naruto was like, you know, don't listen to these bullshit. So, blah, blah, blah. Basically, Zubor forced the others out of Ranger Mode, but when Zubor was about to hit the final blows for Yamato, Yamato's word finally got through Yamato's word just started to get through Zubor, and that's when all the coins that Masagenda feeds you were with to keep him brainwashed on his soul, shot out of his body, and he attacked Mario. It's like telling him that his whole Masagenda I'm not under his control no more. So screw off. So Mario was forced to retreat by Masagenda. So anyway, Zuo to transform back to his human form, and Yamato and others ask him, what's your name? My name's Mondo. They're like, you know, and Mondo was like, you know, I like to gatekeep from Fanny from those destiny control, sort of evil destiny's mind control and brainwashing, and this is how the episode ended. So basically, this episode was okay though. You know, it took a week for this episode to debut, but you know, I wish they would have went a better way when, you know, with the brainwash, you know, feeding Zoo work from the brainwashing, but overall, this episode was okay to me, and it also shows that maybe the other Q weapons can transform into other different animal forms as well, but we just have to wait and see. So anyway, this is Sincere Michael from Screw You Productions signing off.